racist for comments on immigration, which are factual. We're going to show you how the media's anger, of course, is misdirected. And also, Rudy G fires back at Stormy Daniels' attorney. We have our own revelations about Michael Avenatti to share tonight. We've invited him on the show. Hasn't yet appeared. Raymond Arroyo tells us Friday Follies, and it's all about the big change coming to a Starbucks near you. And ending the week on presidential promises kept. Listen to what President Trump said about the prescription drug reform, price reform, and what was rolled out today.
We don't negotiate the price of the drugs. So we're spending perhaps $300 to $350 billion more for drugs buying from our drug companies. When it comes time to negotiate the cost of drugs, we're going to negotiate like crazy, folks. You can look at some of the countries. Their medicine is a tiny fraction what the medicine costs in the USA. It's unfair, and it's ridiculous, and it's not going to happen any longer. It's time to end the global freeloading once and for all.
Alex Azar, the HHS secretary, will be unveiling the policies in the coming weeks. We look forward to that. But first tonight, never-Trumper George F. Will takes a high dive, sadly, off the deep end. His piece in the Washington Post on Wednesday was headlined, "Trump is no longer the worst person in government." Now, can you guess who is? No, it's not. Not Scott Pruitt. No. It's Vice President Mike Pence. Low-key, self-effacing, and loyal Mike Pence? How could that possibly be? Well, George Will has a conspiracy theory, and it's a whopper. He wrote the following. Mike Pence, with his talent for toadyism and appetite for obsequiousness, could, Trump knew, become America's most repulsive public figure. Well, Will's theory is that Trump picked Pence because America would have such a revulsion for his VP, it would take the heat off the president himself. But there's a tiny little flaw in this theory. What makes Pence so repulsive exactly? Well, as proof, Will cited the Post calculations that during a cabinet meeting, Pence praised Trump once every 12 seconds for about 3 minutes with such hideous comments as, quote, "I am deeply humbled." I guess you can't say that. Now, Will doesn't just find Pence's humility repulsive. He also seems to have some kind of issue with Pence's faith. Will wrote, quote, "Pence, one of evangelical Christians' favorite pinups, genuflects at various altars as the mobocratic spirit and the vicious portion require." Well, Will was similarly offended that Pence would call himself honored by the presence of former Sheriff Joe Arpaio at a gathering in Tempe, Arizona. The Veep called Arpaio, quote, "a tireless champion of the rule of law." According to Will, Pence's repulsive humility, piety, and respect for the law make him, quote, "the authentic voice of today's lickspittle Republican Party." Well, Will's absurd accusations were gleefully picked up by the feedback loop on the left as an opportunity to smear the vice president.
Who is Mike Pence? I don't know. You know, he doesn't really seem to have core convictions or beliefs beyond whatever Donald Trump's decided they are.
He's striking this balance, trying to be, you know, the man that will inherit the mantle of Trump, but at the expense of his own persona.
There are two kinds of vice presidents. There are those who are accused of being so out for themselves and nursing their own ambitions that they're not serving the president who picked them. And there are those who are accused of being slavishly loyal lapdogs and so forth. Mike Pence has decided to be the former, or the latter, that is.
He is a titanic, and I mean titanic fraud. He is the most obsequious of all of Trump's cultists in the cabinet. We have never seen such slobbering servility by a high government official in this country than we do with Mike Pence.
Consider the source, my friends. Is Pence really the worst person in government? And why are the Pence haters lashing out now? It's very interesting. Let's ask the vice president's former press secretary, Mark Lauder, Matt Schlapp, he's the chairman of the American Conservative Union, and Democratic Party activist, Chris Hahn. Mark, let's go to you. I've known Mike Pence since, oh gosh, when he was in Congress. He used to actually fill in for me occasionally on radio. We still joke about it. I found that from George Will actually really sad. He's had an unbelievable career as one of the premier columnists, writers in the United States. He obviously doesn't like Donald Trump. That's fine. But I thought it was filled with such low blows. And I wasn't even angry about it. I was actually sad about it.
It's not surprising. Let's remember that in 1986, he wrote a column that called then Vice President George H.W. Bush a lapdog. Here's a decorated war veteran, a hero who would later go on to be a transformational president. So I think George Will has a problem with vice presidents who serve transformational presidents of the United States. And to get to use a baseball term that I know George would like, you know, the best players in the world miss 7 out of 10 times. And in this case, I think he struck out swinging at a pitch in the dirt.
Well, let's go to you, Chris. I think there were overtones in this column that George wrote, and he was picked up by a lot of media figures, as happens on cable news. Someone writes something, we're talking about it. And he talked about how he genuflects at the altar. It was imbued with all these religious overtones, and it seemed really condescending to me, condescending about Mike Pence's faith, almost questioning Mike Pence's faith. Oh, you're not a real Christian. I mean, he didn't write that, but you could read between the lines, and that's right. And I say this as someone, I like George Will. And, you know, a lot of people don't like George Will who watch this show. I actually like him. I've known him for a long time, and it pains me to say this, but I thought the column was beneath him and filled with low blows and not at all in any way illustrative of the man who Mike Pence is. And he's a wonderful person.
Well, look,
and I think a very effective vice president.
Well, the column got picked up broadly because the vice president decided to plagiarize Richard Nixon during the Watergate scandal that morning that the column was released. And I think, look, while I do think the tone was harsh, it's not like George Will said his opinion doesn't matter because he's about to die, which is something that's been said inside the White House these days. So I think we got to back off on this is such a bad thing. Let's face it, the vice president is the bootlicker in chief in this administration right now. He is the one who praises the president most. He kisses his butt most. And what's sad about it is that in 2020, this president will drop him from the ticket because this president cares about ratings. And who he picks for his vice presidential candidate at the convention will be the biggest ratings night of that week. So, Mr. Pence, you might want to stand up to this president a little bit because he's not going to stand by you in the end.
Mike's going to take a swing at this, but before he does, were you concerned about Vice President Biden taking on Obama? Because I'm trying to remember, he never did. When did Vice President Biden take on Obama for screwing up the Obamacare website, for screwing up Benghazi, for screwing up the trailing of journalists, for hounding people who applied for IRS status? When did Biden come out and challenge Obama's abuse of power? When did he do that? Never,
Laura,
Matt,
when did any vice president
ever really
do that?
So why are you going after Mike Pence like that? You didn't criticize Biden for it because you know that vice president's role is to support the president of the United States. Go.
Why is Mike Pence being attacked? You know why he's being attacked? Because it's about pride and ego of these never Trump writers. They can't really admit that the agenda is the most conservative agenda we've ever seen, that he's actually doing what he said he would do. And you know what Mike Pence is doing? A man with a 99% voting record with the American Conservative Union. I don't know what he ever got wrong, but I guess he got one thing wrong one time and all the time was in Congress.
He disputes that. But.
Yeah, he disputes it. But the point is this. You get attacked by these people because they think we're deplorable. They don't think we have any moral standing to make the case that what Donald Trump is doing is the right thing.
And I'm telling you, Mark, when Hillary talked about the basket of deplorables, Obama talked about the bitter clingers, George Will, in this moment, has more in common with their view of middle America from where Mike Pence came than he does with the conservative voters across America who said, we fed up with these parties, we're going to go for someone who's going to take a wrecking ball to the old Washington way. It's elitist, it's snobbish, and it's unbecoming. It's unbecoming. And so millions of Americans who support this administration are horrible, awful, racist, xenophobic, terrible people. Really? Good luck building a movement on that idea.
This is not the first time this has happened. The same thing happened in 1980 when the American people turned their backs on the mainstream Republicans who had another preferred candidate and elected a strong leader like Ronald Reagan. They did it again in 2016 in President Trump, and the elitists can't get over it. They haven't gotten the memo.
Trump doesn't keep a thesaurus and Thucydides by his bed, perhaps. You know, George Will, you know, it's always the seven-syllable words everyone has to, look them up when he... Okay, that's fine. And I like that. That's kind of quirky about Will. I like that. But go ahead, Chris. My concern here is that the timing of this is curious. They're striking out on Trump. Trump's numbers are going up, so they think they can gin up something on Pence. I mean, Trump's numbers are improving day by day by day because the results are there for the American people.
Well, nobody's really going to base their numbers on Trump on what Pence is doing. I just think that George Will had a feeling about Mike Pence based on what happened in New Mexico when he went, excuse me, in Arizona, when he went out there with Joe Arpaio. Look, I think a lot of people have reasons to think Joe Arpaio is somebody who should not be touted by the vice president or the president. Joe Arpaio disobeyed a court order. Joe Arpaio, what he did out there was racist in many people's eyes. So I think George Will sees that. And he says, look, this is not the Republican Party. This is not the conservative movement that he grew up with, that he likes to see. And he would like to see Mike Pence be the backbone of conservatism to President Trump. Because let's face it, President Trump became a conservative about 4 years ago. Mike Pence has been a conservative his entire life. So if Mike Pence is becoming more like Donald Trump instead of bringing Donald Trump more like Mike Pence, then conservatives are going to have a problem with that. And I think that's what George Will was lashing out about it. And look, you want people to talk about it, you better say some crazy things.
Well, you're doing good at saying some crazy things, and all I would say is this, which is, do we want to win or do we not want to win? I know the president talks about if we won enough, we're tired of winning. Okay, but here's the deal. Conservatives are actually getting more done, and we're in a window where we can get even more done than we've ever gotten done.
Azar is going to be one of the big rock stars of this administration. The HHS secretary is not usually someone who gets a lot of attention. I've known him for 25 years. He clerked with me at Supreme Court. Brilliant. He could have been a cabinet secretary of many. He could have been AG. He could have been anything.
Right.
But he's doing this because we got to get this prescription drug stuff. This has to be tackled the right way. He's going to do a lot more. He got Bob Light. He's got Wilbur Ross. Hold on, Chris.
John Bolton.
These are people of real substance who are doing really hard work. And I think it really irks people who are never Trumpers and a lot of the Democrats, because it's like they're throwing stuff up against the wall. And I'm telling you, when Steve Schmidt, because he ran a great campaign with McCain and Palin.
Where did he get
when
these
he wasn't
words?
Trashing Palin, by the way. Steve Schmidt said this today. Let's watch.
We've listened to this guy for many, many years in this country on his moral high horse, assaulting the dignity of gay people across the board. His moral preening is famous throughout the land.
The same vice president who just swore in Rick Grenell, gay American, to be the new ambassador to Germany.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you're
really
a faithful Christian, as he is, he's by nature homophobic. I mean, this is where we are in the country. You can't disagree.